Good morning, students. Myself, Rashmi Yande, your science subject teacher. Students, first of all, welcome into the 8th standard. In 8th standard, in this science subject, total 19 lessons are there. Some are related with biology, some are related with physics, some are related with chemistry. Today we are going to start our first lesson, that is living world and classification of microbes. First of all, we have to understand the meaning of living world. Living world, that is certain criteria is there through which we can bifurcate animals into living and non-living. For example, growth, reproduction, movement, development, these are the certain criteria which can we observe into the living thing. Non-living things are dead ones, they can't move, they can't change their place. These basic things, from that we can conclude that this is a living and this is the non-living. After that, in living world, different species are there. Plants are there, animals are there, microbes are there. What is the meaning of microbes? Microbes are nothing but the microorganisms. Microorganisms, they are very small, too small, which can be only observed through the microscope. That species are called as the microorganisms or microbes. In this lesson, we study the classification of microbes. Is it really important? What is the reason for this classification? Then how it get classified? First of all, first point, it is what is the need of the classification and what is the meaning of biodiversity. Bio, that is the living things, diversity, that is nothing but the variety. In living species, different varieties are there, which is collectively called as biodiversity. And due to that, we have to classify these living things into proper groups, subgroups, kingdom, subkingdom. Last year, we learned that all the living organisms on earth have adapted according to geographical regions, food ingestions, defense, etc. While adapting, many differences are observed in the organisms of same species too. Adaptation, that is certain changes, they are occurring into the body of that species. Why this adaptation takes place? To match up with the environmental changes. Jo bhi environment mein changes hote hai, un changes ke saath khud ko match up karna zaruri hota hai. Then only we can survive. Yes, and for this purpose, this total concept is called as the adaptation. So while adapting, many differences are observed in the organisms of same species. Species are same, but there are many differences are observed while these changes are occur in their body. According to 2011 census, around 87 million species of living organisms are found on the earth, including land and sea. On land, the organisms or creatures they live, they are called as the terrestrial animals. And in sea, in water, whatever the animals, plants, they survive, they are called as the aquatic animals or plants. So here, if you observe, 87 million species are there of living organism, and to study them properly, because each and every organism, they have the different characteristics. From that, some of them have similar characteristics. According to these, we have to bifurcate them or classify them properly, so we can understand their characteristics properly. To study such a vast number, it was essential to divide them into groups. So groups and subgroups were created considering the similarities and differences among the living organisms. This process of dividing living organisms into groups and subgroups is called biological classification. This is the definition for biological classification. We can say the process of dividing the living organism into groups and subgroups, it is called biological classification. Please underline or highlight this definition. Next, it is who classify properly. Here, if you observe in this purple color box, different scientists contribute, they give their invention, they give their theories, they give their classification according to the characteristics. But the universal accepted classification is given by Robert Harding Whittaker. In 1920 to 1980, his lifespan is there. He was an American ecologist. In 1969, he divided living organisms into five groups. So his classification, it is also called as the five kingdom classification. For this classification, Whittaker considered following criteria. For example, students, this is very simple thing. School में बहुत सारे बच्चे हैं. Suppose एक school है और उसमें thousands of students are there. From that, first of all, first criteria that school decided, that is according to the classes. In first standard, in second, in fourth, fifth, in tenth, this type of classification is there. Yes. After that, suppose class-wise classification is over now, but numbers are more, then we make the divisions. A division, B division, C division according to the number of students. And in this way, we classify the total number of students in that school. Like that, अगर हम ये क्लासिफिकेशन नहीं करेंगे तो क्या होगा, कौन सा स्टूडेंट कौन से क्लास में है, क्या है, कुछ भी हमको समझ में नहीं आएगा. और प्रॉपर अंडरस्टैंडिंग वी हैव टू क्लासिफाई देम. सो हियर आल्सो सर्टन क्राइटेरिया इज देयर फॉर दिस क्लासिफिकेशन. फर्स्ट क्राइटेरिया, इट इज द कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ऑफ सेल स्ट्रक्चर. कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी, सेल इट इज अ कॉम्प्लेक्स and simple also. According to that, prokaryotes and eukaryotes, or prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic, this is the first criteria. Now, what is meaning of prokaryote? You can write down here. Here a chart is there, na? Here write down meaning of prokaryotes. Prokaryotes in which nucleus is not bounded by nuclear membrane. Or in simple word, we can say that nuclear membrane is absent in prokaryotes, and in eukaryotes, nuclear membrane is present. Nuclear membrane is nothing but a membrane, a cover-like structure around the nucleus, which is called as the nuclear membrane. So in prokaryotes, it is absent. In eukaryotes, it is present. This is the basic characteristic of prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Second one, complexity of organisms. That is unicellular or multicellular. Unicellular, that means only one cell is there. Multicellular, that means many cells are there. According to that also, bifurcation is there. Third one, mode of nutrition. For example, first, plants, they are autotrophic, photosynthetic. Auto means self, trophic means nutrition. Plants kya karte hai? With the help of photosynthesis process, they make their own food. Yes, therefore they are called as the autotrophic. Fungi, they are the saprophytic. What is the meaning of saprophytic? Saprophytic, that is nothing but which depend upon the dead organisms or decayed matter. They are called as the saprophytic. For example, fungi. Third one, animals. Animals are heterotrophic and ingestive. Why they are called as the heterotrophic and ingestive? Because animals are depend upon other plant or animals for their food purpose. Proper digestion and proper complex structure inside the body is there. So this is the third example of third criteria, that is mode of nutrition. Fourth one, lifestyle. What is meaning of lifestyle? For example, plants, they are producers. Animals, they are consumers. Fungi, they are the decomposers. In this way, according to lifestyle, it is the fourth criteria. Fifth one, phylogenetic relationships. That is prokaryotic to eukaryotic and unicellular to multicellular. Development. How there is a development is occur. So these are first, second, third, fourth, fifth. These are nothing but the criteria on which classification is there. This chart 1.1, five kingdom system of classification. Observe carefully this chart. Living organisms mainly bifurcate into two types, prokaryotes or eukaryotes. Prokaryotes, they are unicellular. First kingdom in these, it is the Monera. Second, here prokaryotes are over. Only one kingdom is under prokaryotes, that is the Monera. Here, second part of living organism, that is the eukaryotes. Eukaryotes are divided into two types, unicellular or multicellular. Unicellular organisms, they have kingdom second, that is the protista. Multicellular organisms again divide into three kingdoms. Third kingdom, it is fungi, in which cell wall present, but organisms can't perform photosynthesis. Therefore, fungi are saprophytic in nature. Kingdom fourth, it is planti. In these, cell wall present and organisms can perform the photosynthesis. In plants, photosynthesis is occur. Why? Because in plants, chlorophyll present. Chlorophyll, it is a green color pigment, which is very essential for photosynthesis process. Fifth kingdom, it is the animalia, in which cell wall is absent. No cell wall. In this way, this is the five kingdom system or five kingdom classification. One by one, we discuss the five kingdoms. First kingdom, it is the Monera. Here a small activity is there. Take a small drop of curd or buttermilk on a clean glass slide. Dilute it with a little water. Carefully keep a cover slip. Observe it under high power compound microscope. What did you see? A rod like microbes, which are nothing but the lactobacilli bacteria are there. Mainly it is present into the milk. All types of bacteria and blue green algae. Algae, that is nothing but shewal. Shewal jisko bolte, green color ka. So blue green algae are included into the kingdom Monera. Characteristics. Now, which are the characteristics of the kingdom Monera? Why are they are called as the kingdom Monera? So here, first characteristics, all the organisms are unicellular. Only one type of cell is there, unicellular. Second one, they may be autotrophic or heterotrophic. Both types are there. Self mode of nutrition is also there, and they are depend upon other also for their nutrition. Third characteristics, these are prokaryotic cells without distinct nucleus or cell organelles. Cell organelles, that is nothing but the inside the cell different parts, that is cell wall, nucleus, nuclear plasm or nuclear membrane, cytoplasm, these are all things called as the cell organelles. So these are without distinct cell organelles are also absent, and nucleus is also, proper nucleus is also absent. These are the characteristics of the first kingdom, that is the Monera. Clostridium tetani, Streptococcus pneumoniae, which causes the pneumonia, Treponema pallidum, Vibrio cholerae. Here Legionella pneumoniae, Staphylococcus aureus, Salmonella typhi, Clostridium botulinum. These are the name of these organisms from kingdom Monera. From these all, they causes the disease in our body. Typhoid disease is occur or form due to the infection of the Salmonella typhi. Vibrio cholerae, which is responsible for the disease of cholera. So these are the certain characteristics of the kingdom Monera, and these are the certain examples. Common example, it is a lactobacilli, which is a useful one and which commonly present into milk curd. Second kingdom, it is the protista. Here if we take one drop of pond water on glass slide, and if we observe under the microscope, we can observe the microbes with irregular shape. They don't have a fixed shape like kingdom Monera. Here proper shape is there. A spiral shape is there, rod shape is there, chain like structure is there, cluster, grapes like clusters are there. So these are the cocci, that is the circular shape. So a fixed shape is present in kingdom Monera. But second kingdom, that is the protista, first common characteristic, it is the, they don't have a proper regular shape, irregular shape is there. These are amoebae, that is the amoeba. It is a very common amoeba, paramecium, euglena. So which are the characteristics? First, it is the protista are single celled organisms with well defined nucleus enclosed in a nuclear membrane. It is a single cell, that is unicellular, but in that proper nucleus is there and nuclear membrane is also there. This is the nucleus, and around that a circular loop like structure is there, covering like structure is there, which is called as the nuclear membrane. Second, they have pseudopodia or hair like cilia or whip like flagella for locomotion. Locomotion, that is they can change their place, they can move from one place to another place, and for that purpose they have cilia. Cilia, that is nothing but this is the structure. These are the flagella or tail like structure, hair like structure or whip like structure, which is called as the flagella. Third characteristic, it is the autotrophs. Their nutrition, it is the self mode of nutrition. Example, Euglena, Volvox contain chloroplast. Two types are there, autotrophs and heterotrophs. Autotrophs, that means self mode of nutrition. And examples of the autotrophs, Euglena volvox, which contain the chloroplast. Here you can see the green color pigment is there, and therefore they can make their own food. Heterotrophs, example amoeba, paramecium. These both species microbes, they are the heterotrophs, which are include into second kingdom, that is the protista. Next part we will continue in next lecture. Today's homework, write down this chart, diagram 1.1, five kingdom system of classification in your science notebook. After that, write down only the criteria, and after that third question it is, draw these diagrams, organisms from kingdom Monera and organisms from kingdom Protista. Thank you.